Hi, this is Steve Michelotti of the Azure Government Engineering Team. I'm joined today by Jean-Sebastian, Principal Program Manager on the Stream Analytics team. And we're here to talk about Stream Analytics in Azure Government. So welcome.
Hi, thanks.
So why don't we start out by telling us a little bit, what is Stream Analytics?
Sure, Steve. So let me give you a little few scenarios. So for example, if you have some data, you want to take some real-time decision like fraud detection, like when people are paying in a store with a credit card, you really want that decision to be made very fast, in general, a few milliseconds. You don't want people to walk out of the store and 5 minutes later say, oh, this was a fraud. We should cancel the transaction. People are already out with the goods they just purchased. So there's a lot
We need a real-time detection. We want to know. We don't want to know 5 minutes later. We want to know right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because 5 minutes later, it's too late. And there's a lot of other scenarios, like when you are loading a page on the web, for example, there's a lot of things that need to happen. Like if you are looking for cross-sell, upsell, product also purchased by people who bought that, you want to load that at the same time you load the rest. So you only have about 120 milliseconds to do that. Another scenario, like if you do IoT scenarios, like Internet of Things, if you detect some engine that get too hot, you want to stop them immediately. So you have only a few seconds to react. And after, we also think about warm scenario. So scenario I mentioned before were hot pass scenario, but you can also think about scenario about a minute or more. And after, you go more to batch analytics.
Okay, so we have the IoT scenario, certainly relevant for government scenarios. And then you mentioned warm path, hot path, those as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right, cool. So let's keep going, yeah.
And so Azure Stream Analytics is part of a big Azure family set of products where you can connect to IoT Hub and Event Hub. So that's basically how you get the data flowing from devices, other programs, other business applications.
Okay. So should we think of Stream Analytics kind of like the traffic cop when we're dealing with IoT, or is that not the right way to think about it?
Traffic cop, or even more, like you can do several set of analytics. You can just do simple things like just filtering, aggregation, but you can do very complex analytics, including machine learning.
Okay.
So you can bring your own model, and as the data flows, you can actually take decision based on historical data and score in real time the data that is flowing.
Okay.
So we are talking about millisecond latency. And then you can decide if you do action and alerts. So basically, you can just trigger some alerts and some texts or something like this.
Okay.
Or feed the rest of the Azure ecosystem. You can feed your data lake for further analytics later. So call pass analytics, SQL database, Cosmos DB, and much more.
So real-time analytics, sophisticated machine learning, if you need that. So lots of possibilities there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And
I can see this is how it can fit into a sample architecture, for example.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's really the simple diagram, but you can take several feeds and join the data together. So it's not only one data feed. You can actually take something from IoT Hub, you complete it with something from Event Hub. So the data is flowing, and you augment it with data at rest. So for example, historical price and things like this. And you can then take decision based on that.
Okay. So I can have multiple data feeds flowing in to Stream Analytics, and I can configure it to mash up the data however I want, analyze it in real time, and make decisions.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great.
So that's a simple diagram. And the important thing about Stream Analytics, it runs everywhere. First in the cloud in Azure, so we have 27 data centers, including Azure Government.
Yep.
But also now we run an Azure stack. So basically you can bring your own hardware and you have the full Azure running there, Stream Analytics runs there. So it's very good for privacy, also if you want to run closer to the data. And we go even smaller on IoT Edge. So okay. Think about running on the machine, on the car, everywhere. So you can pre-process the data. You can remove all the noise or all the data that doesn't need to be sent to the cloud. So you can save on bandwidth. You can also make sure you remove any private information so you can be 100% compliant. And then in the cloud, you can do some multi-device analytics and you use the power of big data.
Okay, so we have the compliance, we have the power of the cloud, but we can also run at the edge, Azure Stack and scenarios like that.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
And so a lot of customers are asking, so why do you need this product compared to other product open source? So here I just have all the advantage summarized in one slide. The first thing is it's very easy to use. So it's a simple job service, so you don't need to do to provision some cluster, think about the machine, the upgrade, we do everything for you. It's very productive because we have a very simple SQL language and we have all the tools. So you can do the authoring in the portal, in Visual Studio, VS Code. So you can choose your own environment. And we have zero code integration. I will show that in the demo in just a sec.
Okay.
With about 15 other products. In the diagram before, I show Event Hub, SQL, but we have about 15 of them.
So if I'm someone that's comfortable with SQL, I can be relatively productive with Stream Analytics here.
Yeah, in a few minutes, you can have your first job running.
Awesome. All right.
And it's enterprise grade, so we have 3.9 SLA, and also we guarantee repeatability. Whatever happens, if you stop and restart, we have always the same result. So it's completely debuggable. If you're in mission critical pipeline, you can have two pipelines in parallel with the exact same result. And we guarantee no data loss. Whatever happens, we will guarantee that. And at least once processing, because we guarantee that we never lose anything. And as I mentioned before, a cloud edge stack, so we run near the data where you need to run the product with exactly the same language, exactly the same not form factor, but exactly the same query.
Okay.
So you don't need to learn anything else when you deploy on the edge. You just can take the same query and say, oh, now I have too much data. I want to move that from the edge to the cloud. Let's just take that and then run on at scale in the cloud.
Okay. Write once, run everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Recently we were featured in Forrester as a leader. So when you look at Stream Analytics, there's a lot of competitors, but I just wanted to highlight that this product is coming from years of research from Microsoft Research, implemented in Stream Analytics, and now we are a clear leader in this space.
Okay, cool. All right, so with that context in mind, why don't you give us a little introduction to the demo you're about to show us?
Sure. So let me show you the diagram. So first, the context is I have some data flowing. It's the data from New York Taxi. So we have the trips coming. They tell you where the trip starts with the latitude, longitude, and where the trip stops, how many passengers are there, how much is the trip, and such data.
So real-time analytics on the taxi data, where the trips are going, how much they're costing, that sort of thing.
Yeah. And then we send this data to Event Hub and Stream Analytics. We augment the data with neighborhood data. So imagine the shape of every neighborhood so we know where the trips start and stop. Instead of having just a number from latitude and longitude, we know, oh, this starts from Soho and finish in Chinatown or something like this.
Okay, so is the way I should think about this is the IoT devices are sending the messages to Event Hub and Event Hub is sending them on to Stream Analytics?
Yeah, actually Stream Analytics is taking the data from Event Hub.
Okay.
We are a pool model, so basically, depending on what we need to do with the data, we take the latest data, or if you put 2 hours windows, we will pull 2 hours of data to make the analytics based on this
data. Like a subscription model.
It's not really a pub sub, it's really like a pool model where we will read as much data as we need.
Okay.
Because sometimes, you know, like a query can be very simple. You just want to analyze one point in time.
Yeah.
But sometimes you realize, oh, I want to compare this data to a very long windows of data. So we will take more data for this case.
Right.
And we automatically do that. When you start the job, we look at the query and say, oh, I need 2 hours of data, 2 days of data, and now I start to output data right now.
Okay. Makes sense.
But that's the first step. And after, I send the data to SQL database and to Power BI and to a data lake. So we can have multiple outputs. And depending of the need, I will choose one of these. For real-time analytics and dashboarding, I will use Power BI. For long-term archival, I will use my blob storage, so at Azure Data Lake.
Okay, so Stream Analytics is doing the analysis, and then it's making the decisions about where to send the data on?
Yeah, in my query, I will show you what I do. I have several steps and say, this one, make some calculation about geospatial. This one, just send it. We just want to keep it for later.
Great. All right, let's see it.
And last step I will show is basically we are producing all this historical data, and we want to make sense of that. For example, at one point of a day, where my taxi should be. So we can take a few years of data and run a big batch query to calculate what should be the normal behavior or normal pattern for a given day, given hour, given neighborhood.
Yeah.
And so you can detect what is abnormal compared to normal and send some alerts, send more driver to take advantage of additional passengers.
Okay, so we can see anomalies in the data and things that we didn't expect.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's basically the setup. And I can show you the Azure portal. So here I'm in Azure Government portal. And I have all my resources already here, so it's very easy to
see. Okay, so this is a dashboard you set up in the Azure Government portal, so you can, for your specific project, you created this portal so you can click into the resources easily.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I already created everything before for to save some time, and I will just show you what I did in the Stream Analytics job. So first, This is the overview, but I just want to look at the input. I show you, like before in the slide, that we have 15 input and output, and it's zero code. And when I say zero code, basically you just have to click here and choose one of the resources you already have. You don't need to write anything. You just say, I'm in this subscription, I want to choose this event hub where the data is flowing, and you click and you save.
So this is the event hub that we mentioned. This is the input data coming in.
Yeah.
Okay.
And here everything is grayed out because the job is running. So we made sure that you cannot break something that's already running.
Yeah.
Because some people are running very important mission critical things. So when it's running, we make sure you cannot make a mistake and modify things and break your customers. And then you can do that for several inputs. Here I have also the historical traffic data. And also the reference data for the region I mentioned, like so the shape of the neighborhood.
Okay, so some of the data coming in might be real-time data coming in, and the other data sources are reference data that you might use to help make decisions.
Yeah. Okay. And while the neighborhood will not change very often, the historical data can be recomputed with Spark, and you can update it every day, every month. So this one is slow-moving data.
Okay.
And the neighborhood is kind of almost fixed data. And then I can show you the output for this one. I'm sending like, a few things to SQL database, and I have a data lake for long-term archival. And then Power BI will take the data from
there. Okay, so that was what you mentioned before. Real-time we'll see in Power BI, and the long-term archival, a data lake or SQL, whatever, whatever we want.
Yeah. And then all the magic happened in this query. So again, it's grayed out because it's running, but we have like a rich authoring experience here. You can see the color. We have some advice here to tell you, oh, this query, are you sure? To make sure like people know like what happened here, and we give you some warning, some hints saying, if you are doing that, the most efficient way is to do that. So it's very rich authoring experience right in the portal, and we have Visual Studio VS Code in addition to that.
But I can see it just looks pretty much just like SQL, so it can be pretty productive relatively quickly.
Yeah. And if you look at the query, I can give you more and more information about what we do. For example, here I'm taking my data from Event Hub, and I'm basically cleaning the data, only choosing the data I need, like making sure there's no error in the data, you know. Sometimes there's some device, have some issues, they will give you some completely random latitude, longitude. That cannot be possible, or instead of a number, they give you some text or something. So
okay.
Just cleaning the data so it flows nicely later. If you do some analytics, you don't want to have bad
right.
data. And after what I do, I actually also added the location of the Microsoft Store. And so I can see how many pickups are happening next to Microsoft Store. So maybe, or drop-off, if a lot of people are coming here, I get my staff ready to welcome more people.
Okay.
So it's literally these few lines here. I can do geospatial analytics here by calculating the distance between the arrival point and the location here.
All right.
So we have embedded like geospatial analytics. Here I have like a keyword like for spatial analytics here. So it's easier than asking the people to do all the math by themselves. And the same for the neighborhood. So if I look at the neighborhood data, basically I'm checking if my point is in one of the neighborhood I have from the list of neighborhood in New York.
Okay.
And basically, I can also do more simple things, or just tumbling windows to aggregate all the data at minute level. Because we just have so much data, if you want to show in a dashboard, that should be too much. Or even sometimes, like if you want to save it, at some point, 2 years from now, you may not need to have like less detailed data. So aggregate at the minute level.
Okay.
And you can see it's also very simple again, just like these three lines where I just aggregate and grouping by my window.
Okay, so real-time analytics, decision-making, aggregation, you kind of have it all in this query language.
And if you really don't want to do anything about the data, this is even simpler. I just wrote it with this query here.
Okay.
I just take everything from one location to the
okay.
location. So everything is there, all my input, all my query there.
All right.
And the job is already running and accumulating some data here.
Got it. All right.
So I can test it because I have a SQL Server Management Studio here. So I can just test the data is coming here. You see here I have 500 rows. Just load it from my trips. So you can see the shape of the data. I can see the number of trips, the average passenger, because I aggregate at the minute level. So
okay.
Average passenger for this minute in all New York, the average time for each trip. And then every minute I can generate a new window here.
Okay.
So everything looks to be good. I can also do a Power BI, as mentioned here. So I build a dashboard. So sorry, probably I was asking for something, but basically I build my dashboard here based on the data in SQL Server. And what
this is just Power BI Desktop and pointing to the Azure Government location, Stream Analytics you were just pointing at, and this enables us to just easily build the dashboards in this location. Okay.
And so I can take all of the data I created here and mash up with all the data you already have in the data center in SQL or other source. I can see all my data is flowing here. I can explain you what I'm doing here too. Like I have the data in real time here in black, for example, in this graph. Okay. And I have my historical pattern here. So I see we were lower than the historical pattern here. So maybe the taxi company can say, oh, at this point, maybe we have too many people on the road. We can have more break or something. And finally, we reach that pattern here where actually that's close to the normal pattern. So people may need to take back, go back to the car or something like this. And here we have the result by neighborhood. So I broke down with my geospatial query. I broke down all the data I have by neighborhood. Okay. And to know where the trip start. And so I can see some neighborhood are much more active at this time as another neighborhood.
Okay.
So you can combine the data in many ways. And you can also publish real-time streaming data sets. So I can show you when it's live, actually. Power BI can update that in real time. So you can see here the data flowing.
Okay, so here we're actually seeing movement. We're actually seeing the real-time data coming in, and we're because you published this to Power BI online.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
So this one is a streaming data set. And I just put the data here like on the x-axis just for like 5 minutes so we can see real movement here.
Okay. Yeah, and this really brings home the power of the real-time analytics because we see the data coming in real time.
Exactly.
All right, cool. So this has been a great introduction to how to get started with stream analytics on Azure Government. We saw the input sources, the stream analytics, doing the analysis, sending the data, and then seeing how we can output this with real-time reporting as well with Power BI. Okay, great. Okay. Thank you very much. This has been Steve Michelotti with Jean-Sebastian from the Stream Analytics team talking about Stream Analytics on Azure Government. Thanks for watching.